Today, I'm going to show you how to connect and configure H2 database in your Spring Boot application. So H2 database is a lightweight, fast in-memory database, which comes in very handy when you need to do unit testing or need to first prototype a application, or you need an embedded database in your small application. Let's see how we can configure this database in our Spring Boot application. If you are creating a new Spring Boot project from scratch, then you can select the H2 dependency as H2 from here, along with Spring Web and Spring Data JPA to work with H2 database. As you can see, the H2 dependency will be added. So if you need to work with H2 database in your existing application, don't worry, I'll show you how to do so. Here I have an existing working Spring Boot application. Here I'll add the dependency for H2 database. So since this is a Maven project, I'll have to add the dependency for H2 in the pom.xml file. If you are using Gradle, then you have to do so in your build.gradle file. To add the dependency for H2, I have to go to Maven repository website and search for H2, and from the H2 database engine, I'll click on a version, and for Maven, I'll copy this and paste it in the insert these dependencies tag. Okay, so I'm pasting it here. So here, one important thing is, since we are using Spring, we do not need to worry about the version of the dependency, so we can omit this line. And if we want to use the H2 database for general purpose, like as an alternative to MySQL or Postgres for prototyping a feature, then we have to change the scope to runtime. But if we are using it for testing, then we can keep the scope to test. So here our dependency incorporation is done. Now I have to configure the database in the application properties. I have gathered all the configuration in a text file. I'll just copy this and paste it and explain to you what does it mean. Okay, so the first one is database configuration. Here I'm defining the URL, the database class name, the username and password. I have kept the username and password very simple for this tutorial. Then comes the H2 console configuration. So once we are using the database, we need to access the database and see what data is inserted, or create some table or alter the data. For that, we can use a web browser like PHP MyAdmin for MySQL, similar kind of thing. We can do so with this configuration. If we run our application and go to this context path, then we'll see the page for accessing the H2 database. So the last one is JPA and Hibernate configuration. Here I'm defining the Hibernate DDL auto configuration. If we are working for unit test, we can keep it as update or create drop, or as we want. And the last one is database platform for Hibernate, which is H2 dialect. So after this configuration is done, we can work with JPA like a typical database. So our H2 configuration is done. So now we can run our application and check if the database server is running and if we can work with our database. So I have ran my application. It is running on port 8080. Now I'll try to connect to the database from my IntellIJ, and I'm creating a new data source as H2, changing the connection type to in memory and naming the database as Learning Spring, and the connection type is in memory. If there is a menu here to download driver, you have to first download the driver and then click on test connection. So I have already downloaded the driver, this one, and our connection is okay. So now I can click on apply and okay. So now my database is created. I can work with my H2 database. So for web view, there will be a web page, like my application is running on localhost 8080 and the H2 console is set in the application properties as H2-console. So I'm entering on this page. Here I can also provide the necessary credential and connect to my database. to see the database table and all. So this is how we can configure our H2 database, and when we need anything we can create a new table and work with our database. One important thing is the scope. If you are using this for unit testing, then you can put the scope as a test, then the H2 will be accessible in the testing scope. But if you use it for a alternative for typical database like MySQL or Postgres, then you have to put the scope and we have to set the scope as runtime. Okay, so now I can create a new entity in our application and it will automatically create a consecutive database table for that entity as I have configured the DDL auto as update or create. So that's all for today's tutorial. I hope you got the idea how to configure and use H2 database in your application. Thanks for watching.